Google just removed the waiting list on its 1 million context length flagship model, Gemini 1.5 Pro. In this video, I'm going to show you what are the capabilities that it has. So let's dive in. So to access Gemini 1.5 Pro, what you will need to do is to search for Google AI Studio. And you can go to this link of aistudio.google.com. Once you're on this page, you should make sure that you have Gemini 1.5 Pro as the drop down over here selected, and you may require to log in to your Gmail account. And once you have logged in, you will be able to see this window. Gemini 1.5 Pro is a multimodal model, and so it supports images, videos, files, and even uploading the whole folder such as GitHub repositories and code repositories. For the purpose of this demo, I'm going to use this video by Figure AI on their humanoid robot. I will quickly show you what this video does so that you understand the whole context, where this humanoid robot is picking up an apple and sending it to the user. It is picking up a crate, dispensing coffee. And so this is the video we are going to now upload to Gemini 1.5 Pro. So all we need to do is to click on video and then upload button, which will allow you to upload a video. And then you can simply browse through your files and drop the video here. It takes some time to load the video, and so I have already preloaded it in another separate window. And as you can see, the number of tokens that are already used out of the total context length allowed is around 8,000 for this 30 seconds video. So let's start with querying such as, what does this video show? And this is showing the runtime. And what it says is, the video shows a humanoid robot performing various tasks, including picking up an apple, placing it on a plate, and then handing it to a human. The robot is also showing stacking crates in a warehouse and making coffee. The video ends with a robot washing dishes. Pretty much amazing, right? It is able to understand the whole video context of this 30 seconds and is able to capture it very accurately. Now let's try to ask it some more questions around it. Something like, what is the timestamp when you see the robot picking up the crate? And it gives us the timestamp of 7 seconds. So let's just see and make sure that whether it is actually at 7 seconds that this humanoid robot picks up a crate. And you can see the timestamp here. As soon as it is at 7 seconds, you can see that it is actually picking up a crate over here. And Gemini 1.5 Pro understood where the robot is picking up a crate. Now let's try to do something more creative. Let's try to draw an image of an apple. And my drawing is very poor, but I will try my best to draw an apple with a leaf. And let's just take this image screenshot and we will put this inside our prompt over here. And then we will ask it, when in the video is this representation shown? And let's see if it understands that this is an apple. The video shows robot picking up an apple at 3 seconds timestamp. And if we go back to 3 seconds, this is exactly correct, where at 3 seconds it is picking up a apple, which is quite amazing, right? Let's try to also, it is also able to understand text inside the video. So let's just try to ask it, what is written on the chest of the robot? And while it runs, I will just show you at the first frame, it shows this F01 with the logo of figure.ai. And as you can see, it identified that the right side chest of the robot has figure logo written on it, which is pretty amazing, right? But I'm just curious, how did it know that this is Figure AI company's logo? So let's just ask it, how did you know that the logo is of Figure AI company? Because in the complete video, there is nowhere mentioned about Figure AI. I know the logo is Figure AI company because I have been trained on massive data sets of images and text, which includes the logo of many different companies. So it understands it from its pre-trained knowledge, and it has seen Figure AI's company's logo in its previous pre-trained database. After the logo, there is also something written on the right side. So let's just ask, what is written on the right side of the company logo? And it correctly identified that the right side of the company logo says 01, which is quite amazing, right? It is a very minute text and it is very hard to read, but it was able to do a very great job at it. Now let's try to also see if it is able to understand some logical reasoning questions. So we'll go on this website and just try to pick one of the logical reasoning questions. So I will just start a new chat, and in which I will paste this. Look at the series and what number should come next. And it identified 10. Let's just ask it why. And as you can see, it correctly gave an answer for why it is 10, where it is an alternating series between plus 3 and minus 2. And so if we go 7 plus 3 is 10, 10 minus 2 is 8, and so on. And then hence 12 minus 2 will be 10. So the answer is 10, which means that it is able to make these logical reasoning questions. Let's just also try to put an image on top of it and see if it is able to understand from the image the reasoning. So I will just simply take a screenshot and paste the image over here. And it correctly gave the answer that this image basically should have 19 in the next sequence, because the sequence shows a pattern of adding constructive prime numbers to the previous number. So starting with 5, it basically concluded that the number resulting is 19, which is the next prime number. And if we see the answer, it is actually the 19th number, which is correct. So as you can see, now Gemini 1.5 Pro is accessible to everybody, and it has 1 million context length with multimodal capabilities, where it supports images and videos, files and folders. But right now it doesn't support audio, but I think that will also come very soon. I will leave the link to AI Google Studios in the description below, so make sure to check it out. And don't forget to like and share this video, as well as subscribe to my channel. Until next time, this is Anubhav Shrimal. Bye-bye.